here today. Good morning, Christ Church. Good morning. I think my microphone's on, yes? Merry Christmas, everyone. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So glad to see those of you who are worshiping with us here today in our sanctuary. Glad to see you. Glad to see you who are worshiping with us online. We hope that we are broadcasting well to you and that you are worshiping in wherever you are, celebrating Christ's birth. So I say unto us, Merry Christmas. Yes, it's a wonderful day that we celebrate Christ's birth. Let me highlight a few events in the life of our church. First of all, if you are a visitor with us for the first or second time and you haven't connected with us and you would like to, we have at the entrances to our sanctuary a welcome bag for you. And if you would please sign the little connection card and leave that in the small basket that's there. There's also a same basket and a welcome bag for you at the entrance in the back of the church. So we'd like to keep in touch with you and to let you know that you are here, or let us know that you are here. We're grateful for that. And for those of you who are members and friends of Christ Church and you have a Realm app, go ahead and check in. Please feel free to do that. And we encourage you to do that online as well. I would like to also make sure that you are aware of our Christmas Eve schedule. Christmas Eve is this Saturday night, friends. We have at 6:40 p.m. Collective Spirit, which is our contemporary musical ensemble. They will be offering music to lead us in and be our gathering music at 6:40. And then our worship service for the family service starts at 7 p.m. And this has a candlelight service as well. And so it's going to be a joyous, wonderful celebration of Christ's birth. And then later that night, on Saturday night at 11 p.m., we have a traditional candlelight Christmas service with Holy Communion served as well. So I encourage you to be aware of those. Please come and worship with us and celebrate Christ's birth. Then on Christmas Day, which is next Sunday, a week from today, there is no faith formation at 9, and nor is there a first worship service. So the only thing we're offering on Christmas Day is 10:30 worship service here. And it's a worship of lessons and carols. Then New Year's Day, likewise, same schedule. There is no 9 o'clock faith formation or first worship service, but there is only a 10:30 worship service on New Year's Day as well. So do take note of that, friends. I want you to know that you can send your Christmas card to the church family and send it to the church. We'll open it up, put it on the tree, and then when you are in the cookie room, you can glance at all the greetings from people who have been thinking of us this day. Epiphany Sunday is January 8th. I encourage you to be aware. This is a wonderful day as well in the life of our church. We celebrate the arrival of the Magi, and the Three Kings processional takes place in the worship service. So Jenny Jacoby is actually coordinating the movement of that. We're still looking for some of our children and youth to be part of the processional. So please contact Jenny. Her phone number is in your worship bulletin. And we have need for nursery workers on Christmas Eve. If you love young children, we could use your help. So we need some volunteers to serve in the nursery, not only on Christmas Eve night, but also on the 10:30 Sunday morning worship services. So please sign up on the sign-up sheet on the board in the hallway. Bill, why don't you come up and offer your word for about the Christmas fund, if you would, please.
Good morning. Good morning. I grew up in a small town in rural western Massachusetts. And I belong to the typical white congregational United Church of Christ that you find in the center of town. It was a small congregation, as they are very much up there, maybe about 100 plus or minus, and always served, at least in my memory, with part-time ministers, or perhaps shared a minister with another congregation. I came to Lancaster Seminary in 1979, and sometime after that, they called a pastor, I'll call him Mac, and he was part-time, and he was well-liked. And he served mostly small congregations in the hill towns of Western Massachusetts. If, I don't know if any of you have been Western Mass or not, but it's pretty, a lot of small towns. But the churches he served did not always pay into the UCC pension. Test? It's not working. You're going to have to bear with me. Anyway, Max served in a number of small town churches in Western Massachusetts that did not typically pay at least the full amount of the pension into the UCC pension program. He finally retired in my hometown, and he and his wife stayed in their apartment that they were staying in. And they got by on his modest pension and their Social Security. Unfortunately, they were in a tragic car accident. In the car wreck, he was killed. His wife was injured. His wife did recover from the car wreck, but her financial situation became a wreck. It was only through the help of the United Church of Christ Christmas Fund for the Veterans of the Cross that she was able to get by. It's my recollection that she received a pension and Medicare health insurance supplement through the Christmas Fund, and it helped her stay out of poverty. Last year, the Christmas Fund, administered by the pension boards of the United Church of Christ, provided over $1.6 million in pension and health benefit supplementation, emergency grants to active and retired clergy families, and thank you checks to retired servants of the church and their families. Every cent of that money came from people like you and me. So I'm asking you to, once again, please give generously as you're able. You can give today using the envelopes that are in your pews. You can give on, you can use your online or whoever you typically give. Give today or Christmas Eve, Christmas Day, whenever. It means a lot to people who have served in the church. And I invite you to join me and give generously to the Christmas Fund. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill. I also want to call quickly on Amy Adams. She has a word tonight for about our Christmas caroling event tonight.
Good morning. I am so excited for this cantata. I can't wait. I've been looking forward to it all week. And speaking of singing, we are doing Christmas caroling this evening. If you're able to meet us here at the church at 6 o'clock, we have about eight places or eight different homes we want to visit this evening, and it'll probably wrap up closer to 8 o'clock. We do have music sheets, and you don't have to sing perfectly, heaven knows I don't, but just come out and have fun. I can tell you that the people we're visiting are very, very welcoming, and they are really, really looking forward to this. I've had a lot of positive feedback about those that we're going to visit, so it'll really brighten their days, I'm sure. So if you can, please join us, wear your festive hats and attire, and bring some sleigh bells if you have them. Thank you.
Thank you, Amy. As I look around us and I see wonderful view of people coming here to worship God, I also want to celebrate that Jane Book is here. Jane is one of our pillars of our congregation, so welcome, Jane. And I look around and I see Laurel Batten is here. Laurel is also a member of our congregation from years and years and years. She's been away because of COVID, but now you're back, so yay, welcome to you too. What a joy to have you here and all of our guest musicians and our musicians and chancel choir. Today we are offering the Christmas oratorio. So let us worship God in this place, celebrating the music that we share in this holiday season. Let us rejoice in the Lord. Let us rejoice in God, our Savior, because we are people of faith filled with the music of Christmas. Let's worship together.
Good morning. We are the Heslop family. I am Val. This is my daughter, Paige, and Callie. My lovely parents are sitting in the back, Dave and Dory Heisey, along with my great aunt Diane.
Can you believe it? It is the Sunday before Christmas. Soon we shall be celebrating the birth of Jesus.
It's very exciting, isn't it? I mean, everything we've been doing is building up to the birth of Jesus. And now the day is almost here.
I know. As the days get closer, I feel the happiness in my heart grow more and more. I'm reminded of the words the angel said on the first Christmas day. Behold, I bring you good news of the great joy which will come to all people.
Wow. How do you remember those words?
I read them in the book, the big book.
You did not.
Okay, you're right. They're right here on the scripture.
Well, the big book, as you call it, does have great words about how God's love can make joy exist in our hearts. Listen to Jesus' words in the Gospel of John. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete.
Oh yeah, I get it. Having God's love in my heart does make joy exist in my heart too. A perfect gift for Christmas.
Yep, let's light the Advent calendar of joy. We started Advent by lighting the first candle of hope.
Next, we lit the candle of peace.
Last Sunday, we lit the candle of love.
Today, we light the fourth candle of joy. We proclaim the coming of God's love and light in the world, which is given a deeper and lasting joy. Joy is a gift not only for Christmas time, but always.
Let us pray together as is printed in your bulletin. O Holy One, as Christmas draws near, there is an excitement in the air. We can feel a deep joy in our lives, and we see it in those around us. Help us to understand that our joy does not depend on our earthly happiness, but rather on you, O God. May we be filled with your joy as you come into our lives again. O come, Emmanuel. Amen.
Oh,
Amen. Please be seated. We share our faith together, and we often do that by sharing in the joys and the concerns in the life of our church. First of all, it's a wonderful joy to have the chancel choir and our guest instrumentalist and all of our vocalists and our director, Connor Ulrich, to share in this wonderful oratorio by Camille Saint-Saëns. Did I say that right? Close? I got a thumbs up from of our French-speaking people. Saint-Saëns. No? Yeah?
Close enough.
Close enough. But wonderful music that we're about ready to share in as we celebrate Christ's birth on this Sunday before Christmas. And if you look around, friends, you see the poinsettias that are scattered about and placed in wonderful places. Thank you to all of you who have purchased these poinsettias. The listing is on page, it looks like, 8 in your worship bulletin. I believe it is 8. No, sorry, 10. Page 10. So please glance at that. And thank you to Carol Hunter and Kim Wolgemuth, who did the actual job of placing our poinsettias in the congregation. And guess what, friends? We announced that last Saturday was the Christmas holiday parade here in Elizabethtown, and we had a float in the parade. And you know what? We got first prize. In the nonprofit entries. So yes, we celebrate that today. And I also celebrate with you in that my grandson, Hayden Michael Sullivan, is being baptized today in Pittsburgh. That's where Barb is. I couldn't be in two places at once, but I went out there this past Friday and Saturday, and I'm glad to be here with you. But please celebrate in your heart and your mind for Hayden's baptism. We also do 80 plus birthdays in the life of our church, and would you please celebrate with heart, mind, and spirit, and send a card if you'd like to Barbara Cook, who will be 86 years old tomorrow, and Richard Scheide, who will be 83 on Tuesday. So we celebrate with both of them. Happy birthday to Barbara and Richard. The prayer list, friends, is offered for you. It is in your bulletin. Again, I think it's located on page 8. If you would please take those names with you to your daily devotional place, wherever you have prayer time, and remember those folks. But also, if you would please add, there are members of our congregation who are still recovering from COVID, and some of that illness is really quite severe in some of those people's lives. And of course, I ask for your prayers for Pastor Fa, as she is in Lancaster General Hospital. We'll likely be there for today, possibly even tomorrow. We don't know yet, but we'll see. So in our prayer time, let's lift up those joys, those concerns, as we come together as a people of faith. May the Lord be with you. Thank you. Let us pray together. Eternal and holy God, this place where we worship, or wherever anyone is worshiping with us in these moments, it's all about you, and it's all about us recognizing the birth of your Son, Jesus the Christ, on this day where we rejoice in you, O God, our Savior, because you have come to us. You have come to us in the flesh. You have come to us as God walking among us, teaching us. And in Jesus Christ, we have a role model of faith. We thank you, O Lord, that we can celebrate this day, the day before the birth of Jesus Christ. We celebrate with music, and we celebrate with our open hearts. We celebrate with the word that we share. And we're grateful for your gift of love that has come to us. May we truly feel that love be infused into our hearts this day. May the music that we listen to and the music that we have sung and will sing come from our hearts and be lifted to you in praise, because your blessings have been so abundant. So richly have we been blessed that we know that it's very important for us to share the love that you have given to us with one another. So, O God, I pray that each one of us has courage and wisdom to share this love, this holiness that you have offered to us. May we share it with the people who are close to us, who are on our hearts and our minds this day. We share your holy love with people on our prayer list. We keep in mind Pastor Fa, who is dealing with the stroke, and that she is being surrounded by your eternal care, your healing and comforting presence, so that if it is within your will and your way, that she may be able to recover well. We pray for those others who are on our list who are dealing with COVID or are struggling through cancer or dealing with medical conditions. Again, your healing and comforting presence are so vital to them, and we believe, O God, that your presence is a vital asset to every one of their lives as they move through these days. For those of us who feel the heaviness of this holiday season, we ask that your spirit is also a strength, and that when the time comes for your birth again in our celebrations coming up in this later part of this week, that we may truly turn our hearts to you and praise you for this blessed gift. For you, O holy God, are the great gift giver, and you have inspired our hearts to sing and praise you. And we thank you for all of this. We thank you for the ministries in the life of our church. We pray that your wisdom and your life and your love exudes from us to others, that we may be a beacon for those who are searching for a presence of comfort and guidance, of wisdom and grace, of inclusion and acceptance. May we be that place, O loving God. All this we pray in the name of Jesus the Christ, our Lord and our Savior, who teaches us to pray together, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I invite you to listen to these words from Paul's letter to the church in Rome. These words are the opening words of his letter, and in somewhat of a nutshell format, Paul shares his faith. It's the salutation, and it starts out, his letter starts out, I, Paul, a servant of Jesus Christ, called to be an apostle, set apart for the gospel of God, which he promised beforehand through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures. The gospel concerning his son, who was descended from David according to the flesh, and was declared to be the Son of God with power according to the Spirit of holiness by resurrection from the dead, Jesus Christ our Lord, through whom we have received grace and apostleship to bring about the obedience of faith among all the Gentiles for the sake of his name, including yourselves, who are called to belong to Jesus Christ, to all God's beloved in Rome, who are called to be the saints. Grace and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. And we give thanks to God for these words, and may these words inspire us this day. Let us pray. O come, Emmanuel. We know you are with us. May we feel your presence in the music we sing and hear. Please be born in us again. We ask in the spirit of the Christ child. Amen. As I introduce our cantata today, I just want to share with you a couple things. First of all, I love Christmas music. Lots of it is uplifting. Some of it moves me profoundly. The best Christmas carols tell the real stories of Christmas, the message that Christ is coming into the world, that God took on human form, a holy incarnation. And you know, without the real story of Christmas, nothing of God's salvation comes to us. It's the beginning of the fulfillment of God's plan to redeem the human race and bring us into God's realm of love, light, and life. Now, usually I start singing Christmas music and listening to Christmas music in the car and in the shower and other places. And it's all about having that music come into my heart. And I start singing it right after Thanksgiving. It gets me into the spirit of Christmas. And I can just feel that God comes in the music. Ah, if only the sounds of the season on the music channel and Warm 103.3 would play sacred Christmas music a little more than the less secular, because Christ's birth story would be told more often. But maybe that's just me. But Christmas music is so vital, I think, to the story of Christmas, which starts with Christ being born in the world in that little town of Bethlehem. But we have to understand that the foundation of the story goes way back earlier than that, back to the days when God spoke through the prophets recorded in Holy Scriptures. Paul's opening words in his letter to the Roman Christians tells this gospel of God's story in brief, almost like bullet statements. Bullet one, the good news of God promised through the prophets is offered. Bullet two, the good news was coming of God's Son, Jesus, in the flesh, according to David's royal ancestry. Bullet three, people declared Jesus was the Christ, the anointed one, the Son of God with power in the spirit of holiness. And that holiness was shown in Jesus Christ as he was raised from the dead by the power of God. And we, by the risen Christ, have received grace through faith and are called to bring others to faith and obedience to Jesus Christ. That's it. That's the story in a nutshell. Boom, boom, boom. Four bullet statements, briefly stated. And even though a couple of thousand years have gone by, I can't help but feel like Paul's words were written not only to the people that he wrote to in the church in Rome, but we can even say by discernment and perceiving that those words apply to us. That in that simple bullet statement story that opens Paul's letters, his words invite us to receive Christ's grace through faith. His words invite us to share that message of God's good news about Christ in any way that we can to others. Because these stories are precious. These stories are told and protected and were eventually compiled and bound together in a book. We call that book the Bible. And these stories from the Bible get told and retold and shared and reshared and read and reread. That's what we're doing today, friends. We are sharing the message of Christ being born in the flesh and born in the spirit. That's what the Christmas season is all about. That's what our Christmas carols that we sing are all about. That's what Camille Saint-Saëns was all about when he wrote the Christmas oratorio, which our choir is about ready to sing. And we begin to realize that God is present deeply in our lives and in our music. And God comes again in the music. So as we listen to this Christmas music, let us rejoice in God our Savior, for God comes in the music. Amen.
Oh my goodness, we're so blessed with all this talent. Oh, I feel so much more cultured today. It was wonderful. Thank you for everyone. I don't think the Christmas caroling is going to be as good. But some of the choir is going to be with us. So at this time, this is a moment to think about offering our gifts, and obviously a lot of people have offered their wonderful talent and gifts today and their time. This just doesn't happen. There was a lot of time spent rehearsing, a lot of personal time taken to put this production on, and it was just so special. You can also give monetary gifts, of course, to the church, either online or through mail. We have an offering plate up here. If you haven't picked up envelopes and you like to use the paper envelopes, they're out here above the coat rack in boxes, and they're not numbered anymore. It's just take whatever box you would like. And we appreciate all the gifts at this season. And as Bill said earlier, also for the gifts that he mentioned. At this time, I would like to just give a brief prayer. Thank you, God, for all the wonderful talent we got to see here today and their offering of their wonderful voices and their musical talent. And thank you for the good that our offerings do, not only for the church and the functioning of the church, but beyond the church and all the good work that it does in our community. Thank you. Amen.
Thank you.
are now dear friends in Christ. We have worshiped with music and with song, with word and understanding of that word, telling the story. And let the love that comes from God that fills your heart because of that story go out from you this place, so that you, while you've been blessed here in this place, may be a blessing to others. Go now, dear friends, in the peace and the love of our Lord Jesus Christ, who was born to us, so that we may share in God's love forever and together. Amen.